Databricks Notebook can include text documentation by changing a cell to a markdown cell using the %md magic command. Most of the markdown syntax works for Databricks, but some do not. This tutorial talks about the commonly used markdown syntax for Databricks Notebook. We will cover 1. How to format text. 2. How to create an item list and checklist. 3. How to create mathematical equations. 4. How to display an image. 5. How to link to Databricks notebooks and folders. Let's get started. We listed commonly used text styles and the corresponding markdown syntax in the Format Text section. Headings are created by adding a pound sign at the beginning. Bold is achieved by adding 2 stars at both ends. Italic is achieved by adding 1 star at both ends. Strike through is achieved by adding 2 tildes at both ends. Block quote is achieved by adding 1 greater than sign at the beginning. Inline code is achieved by adding 1 backtick at both ends. To escape the backtick in the inline code, use double backticks. A code block is achieved by adding a triple backtick at both ends. To escape the triple backticks in the code blocks, wrap with 4 backticks or 3 tildes. Link is created by wrapping the text with square brackets and the link with parentheses. Horizontal rule is created by 3 dashes. Highlight is achieved by setting the background color in the HTML span tag. Color is achieved by setting the color in the HTML span tag. To add space between lines, we can use the HTML br tag. Databricks Notebook does not support emoji shortcodes such as colon heart colon, but we can copy the emoji image and paste it directly to the markdown cell. Subscript is achieved by adding underscore and curly braces. Superscript is achieved by adding caret and curly braces. Table is achieved using the combination of pipes and dashes. This is the examples for each of the text format discussed. And this is the rendered output. In the item list section, we will talk about creating an ordered list, an unordered list, and a checklist. An ordered list is created by adding numbers at the beginning. An unordered bullet point list is created by adding a dash or a star at the beginning. A checklist can be created by adding cross, check, and underscore at the beginning. The code renders to the output below. Databricks Notebook supports contacts. Below are examples from the Databricks documentation. This renders to the equations below. Databricks Markdown can take images from a URL or file store. To read an image from a URL, we can use an exclamation mark, followed by the same syntax as creating a link. Recall that a link is created by wrapping the text with square brackets and the URL with parentheses. For example, the code here renders to the image below. We can also format the appearance of the image using HTML. For example, the code below specifies the image alignment, line height, padding, and image size. It renders a smaller image in the center of the cell with some padding spaces. To access an image through file store, we need first to upload the image. Using %fsls, we can see that the image was saved under DBFS file store tables. The code renders to the image below. We can also format the appearance of the image using HTML. The code below can be used to link to other notebooks or folders using relative paths. For example, the code here renders to the link to the notebook called DB01 Databricks mount to a WSS3 and import data. In summary, this tutorial talked about the commonly used markdown syntax for Databricks Notebook. We covered 1. How to format text. 2. How to create an item list and checklist. 3. How to create mathematical equations. 4. How to display an image. 5. How to link to Databricks notebooks and folders. If you found the information in this tutorial helpful, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. I publish tutorials on machine learning, deep learning, and big data processing every week. If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please go to grabandgoinfo.com. I will put the link in the video description. This is the blog post for this tutorial. It has all the code and explanations in the video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.